Welcome to today's tutorial. In this session, we'll be diving into the fascinating world of transistors. Transistors, imagine if you could control the flow of electricity like turning a tap on or off. A transistor does exactly that in an electronic circuit. It's a tiny component, but is essential in modern technology, found in computers, phones, radios, and even household appliances. What is a transistor? A transistor is a semiconductor device used to either amplify or switch electronic signals and electrical power. Think of it as a gatekeeper that controls whether electricity can pass through a circuit. Key points: it can amplify signals, making them stronger. It can switch circuits on and off. It's essential in building complex circuits, like those in computers and smartphones. Types of transistors: bipolar junction. Transistor, BJT, this is the classic type with three parts. Emitter, E, where current flows out. Base, B, the control gate that determines if current can flow. Collector, C, where current flows in. BJTs come in two types. NPN, transistor, allows current to flow when a positive voltage is applied to the base. PNP transistor, allows current to flow when a negative voltage is applied to the base. Field effect transistor, FET, uses voltage to control current flow. Its parts are source, S, where current starts. Gate, G, controls whether current flows. Drain, D, where current exits. How transistors work. To understand a transistor, think of it as a water faucet. When you turn the faucet on slightly, apply a small current or voltage, a little bit of water flows through. If you turn it all the way on, increase the current or voltage, more water flows. Similarly, a transistor allows you to control the flow of electric current. Transistor functions in circuits. As a switch, in digital electronics, transistors are used as switches, which allow circuits to process binary data, zeros and ones. When a small current is applied to the base of an NPN transistor, it turns on, allowing a larger current to flow from collector to emitter. As an amplifier, in audio systems, transistors can amplify weak audio signals, making the sound louder. A small input current at the base is amplified as it flows through to the collector, creating a stronger output signal. Example: using a transistor to control an LED materials needed, NPN transistor, e.g. 297, 2N222, LED resistors, 220 ohms for LED, 1 kiloohm for base, battery 9 volts. Circuit setup. Connect the emitter of the transistor to the negative terminal of the battery. Connect one end of the LED to the collector of the transistor. Connect the other end of the LED to the positive battery terminal through the 220 ohm resistor. Connect the base of the transistor to the battery's positive terminal through the 1 kiloohm resistor. Operation. When you apply a small current to the base, the transistor allows a larger current to flow through the collector and emitter, lighting up the LED. Remove the base current and the LED turns off. Practical applications of transistors: computers. Transistors form the basis of logic gates, allowing computers to process information in binary code. Radios. Transistors amplify audio signals so they can be heard through speakers. Power supplies. Transistors help regulate and control voltage and current in power supplies. Summary: transistors are tiny components that can amplify signals or act as switches. They have three terminals: emitter, base,